We're here to go more deeper into Python. Okay, for now, I'm gonna restart my shell. So I restart my shell and let's begin with a concept very often learned in other programming language, but quite different in Python, called as variables. Okay, so what are variables in Python? In other programming languages, you always have something called as a variable declaration or a variable and a variable initialization. Okay, what exactly is a variable? Okay, you might have learned somewhere if you are have a programming background. If you haven't, then this is what you will learn in another programming languages. Variable is nothing but a container which can hold some data for you. Say for example, in your kitchen, you may have multiple things to be stored in the kitchen. Okay, so you may have to store tea somewhere, coffee somewhere, some kind of masala somewhere, and some, you know, you have different boxes for different things. Okay, but you don't store all of them together in one box. In the similar way, you need to store data somewhere in some sort of container, and you need to know where it is. Okay, so this particular data storage in for your particular data storage, where does it happen? This data storage happens for you, right? It happens directly in your computer, or it happens on your controller in something called as the memory. So you have some memory in your computer, or if you have something in your microcontroller. What is a memory? A memory is nothing but comprising of a few locations, just like you have different vessels or different containers to store different masalas. In memory, you have different locations where you can store different data. Each location has a particular address. Now, in other programming languages, this is what you learned. A variable is nothing but a container a location in the memory which can hold some data. In other programming languages, you might have done something called as you might have come across a variable called as integer. It says it can hold integer. Let's say a is equal to 25, and a is equal to 25. Now, so what is this particular function doing? What is this particular line or this command doing? In this particular line, they are defining for you a variable or nothing but a memory location whose name is given by A. The name of that variable is given by A, and that memory location can only hold a particular value that is an integer. So an integer is nothing but a number without decimal points. Okay, this is what you did in other programming languages. Of course, in other programming languages, you also need something called as a semicolon. In Python, you do not need neither this nor the semicolon. All that you have to do in Python is something called as, you can just write simply a is equal to 25. You can just write a is equal to 25. If you want to display a, you can display it by saying a, and it displays it back for you, the value which a is pointing to. Now comes the question, what is a for your programming language? A is nothing but, you can say, okay, A is nothing but the name for your address. It is like a nickname for your particular address, for the address of your memory location. Yes, for other programming languages, but no for Python. Why? Because A is not just another address. It is actually, we can say, A is a reference to an integer object. Wow. So what is the meaning of this, sir? That means you're saying that container, if you know, say in your kitchen you have a particular container, that container can contain, you know, something, but you might not remember, or you don't remember. So what you do is, on top of the container you put a label, and on that label you might write the name of that particular thing which is there inside. So you may say, okay, so you may say that A is nothing but the name that you put on top of that container. Yes, for other programming languages, but no for Python. Why no for Python? Python does not call it with a name, but Python just says, okay, if I say A, it is going to point to that. It is going to point to that particular memory location. Yes, it can point to that particular memory location. But A is not the only name for that memory location. It can be other variables also can also point to the same memory location. What do you mean, sir? What do you mean? That means when I say B is equal to 25, okay, and I say B, enter, it spins for you 25. Okay, so that means, you know, in other programming languages, what used to happen? You used to go to another container, used to put 25 in that, and that container was called with the name B. It was not the same container as A, but not so in Python. In Python, the same container is now being referenced by B also. This is something which is unusual for Python to do so. Sir, how do you prove what you just said? Okay, is there some way to prove it? Yes, there is a way. Okay, let's go to the documentation and see if there is a function which tells me what is the address that A is pointing to. Can you prove the statement that you just said? B is a reference to an integer object 25, and it is pointing to the same integer object as A. So can you prove that A and B are pointing to the same memory location? Yes, I can prove it. If I can get the address that A is pointing out to, and if I can get the address that B is pointing out to, I can understand which particular memory location is being used. Why is this so very important when you learn Python programming? This becomes very important because when you start with higher data types, okay, when you start with something called as lists, and when you use different libraries, and you're just going to deal with a lot of data, you may not want to make this mistake where you want different variables to access the same memory location. You might want to be very careful in handling stuff. So at the outset itself, if we can get our basics right, we will not be, you know, somewhere carried away. Okay, so is there a possibility? Yes, there is.